Another day, another massive round of cuts to Tasmania's public hospitals. Today it was the North's turn. The Launceston General's announced it'll have to slash spending by $100 million over the next 4 years. Unions say community anger against the budget cuts is growing, with Parliament about to receive one of the largest public petitions in decades.
27,000 signatures collected in just 4 weeks. Nurses say they didn't have to twist any arms.
We're an older, chronic, complex community and we really need our health system. And the real people can see the damage that is being done to our health system by the state government.
The opposition leader will table the petition in Parliament tomorrow.
This is the largest expression of public disgust at what a government's doing since 1981. 26,000 Tasmanians agree that this government is not listening.
And the bad news keeps coming. Today, unions were told $76 million has to be slashed from the Launceston General Hospital's budget over the next 3 years. That's on top of the $28 million that has to be saved this year.
It's around 20 extra surgical beds that are going to be announced to be closed, plus about a third of the day procedure unit and a third of the endoscopies are going to be cut by Christmas. These are devastating levels of cuts through our health system, and it's not just in one area, it's right across every sector.
The Royal Hobart Hospital received a bitter savings pill yesterday. About 75 full-time positions will be axed, with at least 24 beds to close. The CEO concedes it's a tough task.
I'm not on track to make full budget, but I'm on track to make a great big dent into the gap that we started with.
And it's not just the cities. Unions say an aged care facility is being outsourced at Scottsdale and a nurse will go at Bishano. The Health Minister insists those changes aren't about savings.
The Northern Area Health Service is trying to create a sustainable service in an area where it has had some challenges. There is no budget saving to be made from the changes that it's making, but it does need to find a sustainable way to ensure that those nursing services are provided.
The one thing that's certain, we haven't heard the last of budget cuts. Rebecca Hewitt, ABC News.